So this, you heard the song Pneuma off the new album.
Yeah.
This is the drummer. It's a drum cam video of the drummer playing this song live in concert.
Is there a produced video for this musical piece? Do they do video?
No.
They don't do video.
No. Like the only, even at their concerts, you're not like, there's no phones allowed at the show.
No, no, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about, do they actually produce musical videos for
They did numbers? For their earlier stuff.
But not now?
No.
Okay.
They did, but there's
a proper order, by the way, about fucking phones.
There's only,
may I say,
yeah.
How many people spoil their moment by trying to record it that they'll never look back on?
Yeah.
What's this about?
Yeah.
They're there. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, they're in full HD in front of your eyes.
Oh, I'm having a rant. Give me tablets. Seriously.
Yeah.
I don't fucking understand it.
No, but you know what that is? That's just... tell their friends, look where I am.
Yeah, it's about showing off.
I have seen people record an entire fucking show. You say, literally.
Why?
They're there. You're living, you're breathing with them.
It's better quality in your eyesight.
You'll never watch it again.
Not only that, but if you go to the drummer and the bass player, when you walk into a venue, if you can feel the drummer and the bass player on your chest, that is a good sign.
Yeah.
You have to feel that pulse.
Yeah, you're locked in.
Yeah.
Do you tell all your audience that?
It's true.
You know, and you have to have, because they say the most important people in the band is the bass player and the drummer.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, when you have all that round you, as I said to you, it's all
you bass player. And you start off as a drummer. Interesting that, isn't it?
Yeah, I started
off. They should say that.
I started off as a drummer, then I became the bass. No, I became the rhythm player, then the lead singer, then the bass player. And now I'm back.
Listen, lads, the point is, get off your phones.
Yeah.
And stay away. Live the moment.
Like
live
I was saying, at their shows, there's no phones allowed.
Absolutely problem.
No.
But you go to a production, a play, and take your phone out and say, I'll watch that later.
Yeah.
No. I want to see Hamlet's speech.
The only time they do at the show, it's the lead singer sort of thing. He will say, like, get your fuck. If he sees a light on in the show, he'll single you out.
Only right.
And there's also ushers going around.
Yeah,
making sure.
Right.
But then at the very end, he'll say in a snarky way, if you want to record the last song, you can. And that's
Is that a snarky way?
It is. He'll be like,
give me some more snark.
Yeah. Not me.
That is a coincidence. Because
but in a snarky way, he'll be like, if you need to get it out of your system.
Apart from the Eagles are the same.
Yeah.
You've ushers going around. But Don Henley was in concert in the Tree Arena, and I went to it. And he was announcing that no anything. And he did say to people, put your light off and all this. And then on the last song, he says, take them digity things out now and go ahead. He's done the same.
Pretty much the same thing.
Yeah.
No phones at the show. And it's honestly, it's great because you're all there like enjoying
in the moment.
And it does feel a lot better.
How many times have you seen a concert and you're looking at the band and then cinema. Yeah. Don't talk about the cinema.
Oh, don't get me started with phones. The cinema.
Anyway, but there we go.
You see, what it is with your phones is, look where I was.
Not
at the gig. Look how far I was away.
It's narcissism.
It is. But the entire production.
You've seen it on Facebook. That when the Titanic sank and everybody in the water, today, you see them on the phones. It's true.
Yeah.
But as I say, live that moment.
Yeah.
Because
be in the moment.
You have to experience.
Yeah, if you're going to drown, for God's sake, be at it.
I was lucky. I was lucky in my time.
Let the hypothermia take over.
Yeah. I was lucky.
Imagine Jack and Rose and the Titanic. We're going down.
Yeah, we're on our way.
Selfie.
But I was lucky.
What do people take for rather than going down?
Can I talk?
I
was lucky growing up because there was no digital things and all that.
Everything was black and white, live.
Yeah.
All the bands are live. Now, we hadn't as many concerts years ago.
Yeah.
But you've seen the band live. You've seen what the guitar player was doing, the bass player, the drummer. But live in the moment.
Agreed.
We're going to live in the moment now.
Absolutely.
I have to see this drummer.
Cans on, eyes open.
This is the drummer. His name is Danny Carey.
Oh.
This is the song Pneuma, live.
Okay.
Right.
So actually, one of you hit space.
Is that an extremely large drum kit?
Yeah.
Intricate drum kit. That's a... He's completely surrounded by his music, yeah, literally.
It's a normal drum kit, but there's clips on it that he can change the sound.
But there's loads of stuff to look. Yeah. What's that behind him?
Yeah. Well, there's a big gong, and then it's like a big... There's a big synth thing above it. I don't know what it's called.
Right, yeah.
It's like a keyboard thing.
He's as busy as an organist in the cathedral, isn't he?
He's just...
look at how everything's going.
Jesus.
You're having a different experience to me because you're a musician. I almost feel like someone's just showed me the trick and I know where the rabbit's kept.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, I am watching it, right? And
you're watching like a musician.
Yeah, I'm watching it and I think it's amazing because the hi-hat, if you're a right-handed drummer, is usually on your left-hand side. Yeah. And he's the hi-hat right in front of him.
Yeah.
But yet, his left foot is walking it. So he must have designed that.
It's a custom thing for him. Oh. Yeah.
But you see, I would never.
Yeah, I know. I don't know
no
either.
No one understood that. Yeah. And in point of fact, I still don't understand what he said.
But it doesn't matter, does it?
But no, what you're getting from this is complete of what I'm getting. I'm enjoying the skillfulness and marveling at it. But I think we had this conversation before about mastery of technique and skill and production. The Eiffel Tower is but the Statue of Liberty with a frock on. You know what I mean? Yeah. We know that there's metal underneath it. But I'm more interested in the Statue of Liberty, but I can admire the structure of the Eiffel Tower still standing. As in, Paddy is getting every moment of this because he's a musician.
Now, do you see what he's doing? Like, it's, yeah.
No, but I understand how busy he is. But I can't break it down as well as a musician can.
But
well, we're having a different view.
Do you want to pause it? No.
I'm enjoying it.
Okay. But
when you see it, when you listen to it, I had in my mind that someone else was playing that timpani.
No.
It's him.
Yeah.
It's playing it with his right hand and he's going round. Yeah. You know, and I just...
Like, look at this. It's incredible.
Incredible. Incredible. Not only that, he has... I'm sure there's technicians that set up his drums, but he has it right.
Yeah.
When you see him going for a crash cymbal and then one behind without even looking, he knows where it is.
Yeah.
But what...
he could do that blindfold, I should imagine.
Well, look, he's playing like four different things. Like,
he is, yeah.
Look what he's doing now.
You see, what he's doing is...
What's he with the leg there?
Yeah, do you know what he's doing there? That's called syncopating. He is syncopating round without playing a beat. He's just going round. But yet, he's still keeping the beat with his right foot. Yeah. You know,
is that what he's doing here with this?
Yeah, that's syncopating round everything. Right, but if you look at his right foot, it's keeping that beat going.
Is he operating this?
Yeah, the hi-hat is on his left.
Right. That's always over the two gum together.
Yeah, but the hi-hat is usually over here. He's an incredible man, my God. Now, I've seen drummers, and I have serious admiration for the drummer with Def Leppard, who lost his arm. Yeah. I have incredible admiration for him, but I have never seen it like that. And he has all his things around that he can change his drums. Even though they are a normal kit, he can change it to whatever he wants. It's incredible looking at this. You see the right foot there.
So he's doing the bass.
No, he's doing a double up. If you notice, the hi-hat is open now, so he's not, you see it there, it's open. He's not using it. He's using the two bass drums. He's got a double pedal.
The other one's at the bottom.
Yeah.
Right. It is something to behold, isn't it?
That is an art in itself. Do you notice something? You could watch that all night.
Yeah.
Honestly.
You could.
Oh.
Because you're getting so much from it.
And if you look at a snare, it's only got one white skin.
What does that mean?
He must prefer a skin on the snare, but he's all different types. It must be his own design skins.
I see there at the beginning, he has a 6.5-inch drumstick. It's customized to his specification. Yeah. What's his name? David Carey?
Danny Carey.
Danny Carey.
Do you see that?
It said that at the beginning, yeah.
You see the name down the bottom? They're the makers of the drumsticks.
Vic Firth.
Yeah.
Right.
You know.
Nobody had mentioned sort of a little caption that they're customized drumsticks in specification.
But
what is the standard length of a drumstick?
What?
Is there a standard length of a drumstick?
Oh, it's all different. There's pro logic in it.
That's 16.5-inch.
Yeah.
And that's what mentioned there. So is that longer than usual?
No, it's thicker.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have different. Now, to look at them, they are in between a heavy drumstick and a light. But
and he's not wearing cans.
No.
Do they not usually wear cans?
But sometimes they have this.
So we can hear the rest music.
In-ear monitors.
Has he got ear monitors on?
No.
No, he doesn't use them. I don't think he does. It looks as if he does.
So how can he hear the other guys up front?
You have side fills. Your speakers at the side.
Right, okay.
But because what he's doing is, what I think what they're doing, I don't think any of them have the in-ear monitors.
No, they don't play to a click.
No. But are they not clicked there, the drums? The drums have click tracks.
No, he doesn't play to a click.
No, but when you see him.
Is that the vocalist in the background with the spiky hair?
Hold on,
who's in the background?
That's the singer.
That is a vocalist, so he stays way back.
But he just came back round. But he's right. Like, he'd be off to his left, like directly there.
You know something? That's it. That's it. I seen it all. I'm so delighted that I seen that. I could see a drummer right round a kid a drum.
You're right, son.
But I've seen it all. Where I thought where there was. You remember you were saying the rattlesnake? I thought there was someone else on the stage while he was playing, hitting that timpani.
I'm enjoying listening to you. Him. Because you're breaking it down for me.
You know, it's unbelievable.
But I didn't need to see that.
Not only that. Then
I didn't need to see that.
But I don't get the technicalities of it either. But I just liked seeing.
I admire it.
Look at all the sounds he just made. Yeah.
I admire it. I think it's wonderful, but don't ever do that to me again.
Yeah. But do you know what?
I don't want to know where the rabbit comes from.
Do you know what I.
The lady is cut in half. Yeah.
I think it shows it'll give an appreciation for stuff going forward. You're like, all the detail that, it's not from a recording.
Well, yeah.
Oh,
it's happening in real time.
But I did believe
it. I would say, I'd say most of their stuff, I wouldn't say they're in the studio. I'd say most of the stuff are recorded on stage.
Do you think?
Yeah, because imagine the guy in the studio micing up all them drums.
I did listen to an interview with the drummer where he said like they'll go to some place where there's like $1 million worth of mics.
Yeah.
To get this. Like it's a proper recording space.
Well, that's what I mean.
To get his drums mic'd up properly.
It has to be a venue.
But then how does he take that live? How does he move with that? But obviously he does. But
well, now with the million, I'm just for the albums, I'd say. Like, it would take a lot of microphones mic'd up to his drums to record it all.
All of those pieces.
And high quality, high fidelity microphones.
But when you look at his kit.
Yeah.
You have your normal tom-toms and all this.
Yeah.
But the timpani, now the timpanis came out in the 70s. And a few people had them. But he still is one of them. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's a timpani.
A timpani is a drum, but it's got a metal bottom on it. You can actually turn that and you can make the sound higher or lower.
Okay.
All right. Okay.
But what amazed me was where his hi-hat was.
Yeah.
But I was watching it and then I seen him hitting it. But I can hear a hi-hat opening. It goes psst, psst. Mm. And I said, but he must have it set that when he hits it hard, it sounds that way. The bag must be open.
Yeah.
But it's not. It's when I seen his foot and then he opens it. So it's custom made for him.
Mm-hmm.
But it is doubled up on the bass drums and is syncopating. Like he's getting round. He's playing, keeping the beat with his right on the kick.
Yeah.
He's syncopating around the drums and you're thinking,
like, this is in different time. This is different. This is
that's
different.
That's what I mean.
This is different.
That I appreciate. I can't understand the breakdown.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I absolutely
it's all
appreciate
different
that.
Time. It's octopus.
It like is.
Stuff.
Someone like, mentioned in the comments.
What? Maybe, yeah.
Tool is like octopus meets. I'll have to go back. Yeah. That was very clever.
It's, as you say, he is doubling up on everything.
Mm.
You know, and yet he is still keeping the beat straight.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know. And for the guitarist and the bass to know where they are.
So it goes back to what you said, Paddy. These are musicians.
Oh.
These are crafted, skillful.
They're not, I wouldn't say
they're maestros.
They're not musicians. They are wizards. Wizards.
Ooh.
Okay.
They are musician to magician.
I've never seen your man Kerry play before, but I'll be watching it for his stuff. Just to look at him.
Yeah.
Because when you said we're only getting the drummer, I thought that it was he was there on his own. He was just doing a few.
Yeah.
This guy is just here.
Any other footage of any other band members?
Is there any music shops opening to get a kit like that?
That I think that kit costs a fucking fortune.
That kit, not a ton.
See all the electronics behind them.
But here,
that's what I mean. Yeah,
it's got a whole rig there. There's stuff there. The big things behind
that, that's what I was trying to say.
Is he airdropped into it?
Yeah,
it's a cockpit, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. But
fighter pilot.
I remember back in the '80s, the click track came out. The click tracks are only about that size, and the stick on.
Is that literally just to keep you in time?
A metronome.
No. But what is a click? What does that mean?
A click track is It's a circle amplifier, right? It's like a microphone. It's stuck onto your drums or underneath.
Right.
But what does it keep you in sync?
No. What you can do is You can go into...
I don't know either.
No, you can go into any venue.
Right.
Any venue, like, and we say you wrote a song, but it was done on a jazz kit.
Right.
You can turn your kit with them sounds. Or the clicks is your sound. So you can turn all the sounds of your tom-toms, your snare and everything to the sound you want. That's where the click, that's what I said, is a click track. Okay. That's why.
But then there's also playing to a click, which is like 1, 2, three, 4, 1.
And well, that is metronome.
That's in your ear.
That's a metronome, yeah, that's but a they metronome. Don't play it to that.
Well, that's my fucking thing.
Yeah, but to get different sounds, you can turn your that's when I thought he was playing the timpani, that it was a click. It wasn't. That was the timpani.
Yeah.
But the rest...
Oh, I know what you mean. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know...
Well, he has all those electronic pads there as well.
Yeah.
And I think... I think from his laptop, he's able to program these electronic pads to be like, this could be a conga, this could be a bongo, this...
That's
like, he's able to change that as well.
That's what's called click tracks.
Okay.
They're on it. But when you were saying he can see it, could he see us?
No.
No, I'll tell you one thing. As I said to you, audio art, if you're listening.
Yeah.
Visual art on a drummer. I would love to see the cameras on the other fellas maybe next time. Just individually.
Okay. Righto, Joe.
Is that it?
That's that one, yeah.
Oh.
Seen a wee one.
Ta-ra.
Listen, thank you all for... Don't forget, subscribe. Keep subscribing to this channel. But and we will look at other bands, and we'll even look at your
but
band.
I wanted to. We're doing covers, some covers.
Yeah,
yeah.
And I wanted to. And we could find Susan McCann doing "Slap Your Bitch Up."
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Which we or Big Tom doing
"Straight Out of Compton."
Straight Out of Compton, Big Tom's version. Be fabulous, right. Wouldn't
but
it?
But there is covers that I cannot stand. Is anyone doing an Eagles cover?
Okay.
Because you're a purist.
Unless.
We can't play Eagles anyway. No, copyright.
But you're a purist.
No, because there is good one. I thought Michael Bublé came out with Hard Day Tonight, and it was a big band, so I thought it was great. But there was a few people came out with shite. But
that's a technical.
We'll end this one for now.
Yeah.
Ta-ra, everybody.
I really enjoy it. I hope you all enjoy this. Do tune in. Give comments if you want us to look at another band. We are just too horny. I'm a musician and radio presenter. This is a well-known actor. He was in The Invisible Man.
Shut up, you.
This is Tyler. He's going to the bathroom. We'll be right
Alvaro
back.
Alvaro Lacasey.